Welcome at video 9 on the Yamaha Montage and Modix synthesizers. In this video, we are going to have a look at the performance screen. We can select a sound via category search. By the way, quick tip. Repeated presses of the category button steps through the different banks. We can also use the live set to select the sound, and also here the repeated presses of the live set button steps us through the different banks. Let's select a sound and we can immediately start to play. But if we would like to have a little bit more insight on what this sound actually contains, then we can press the performance button, and that brings us to the performance screen. At the very top of the screen, we see the name of this performance. And other quick tip, we can change the sound here immediately by simply rotating the dial wheel or using the increase or decrease buttons on the user interface. The steps that it takes are the steps that come from the category screen. So it's exactly these performances that you see, which may be, well, not very useful. It would have been a bit more useful maybe if it would step through our live set screen, because that's a screen we build ourselves and we put our performances in sequence. But okay, it still is possible and it might be helpful sometimes. The icons here on the right, they show us some features of this particular performance. Like this one has the wave synthesizer and the FM synthesizer in use. It has motion control and it has seamless sound switching. This tiny star means that I made this performance one of my favorites. And this blue flag that shows up only after I tweak the sound, and it means that I have not yet saved it. Never forget, if you created the perfect sound, to press this store button on the user interface to save your sound with a new name. It will become a sound in your user bank. Next are the knobs. Apparently the creator of this sound gave four of the knobs a function, and well, let's just try them out. We can rotate them and see what happens. Yes, that changes the sound drastically, and this one, yeah, that adds a little guitar, and this one, it adds some string sound to it. Well, that's nice, so we can immediately live change our sound. And of course, we also have the super knob, if it has been programmed. Yes, it has, and as we can see, it changes all the knobs at the same time. So, very nice for live performances, we can drastically change the sound. But that's not all. These knobs always have dual functions. We can press on the user interface the button above the assign button, and we can now see that the texts over here have changed. They are the same as the text that are printed in white above the knobs. And we can now change the cutoff frequency for this performance. So yes, it is possible to drastically change the sound by using all the parameters here available to us. The next video we will dive in much deeper on these knobs and how to work with them, and also how to create your own assignments, which of course is a challenge. Next we have the different parts of which this performance is built up, and it shows here the names, or if we would tap the type name field, it can change to show the type the instrument categories. And it's just a personal preference what you like to see over there. Then we come across a row of toggle switches to switch the arpeggiator and the motion sequencer on off. Let's have a listen. The arpeggiator, if I switch it off, well, that changes the sound in this case drastically, because of course the arpeggiator in Pearly Gates is a big part of the fun. The motion sequencer, I can also tap that to switch it on or off. In this case I don't hear a lot of difference, but hey, it's there. Then we also have a arpeggiator hold function that we see over here. Let me introduce the drums, and now the drums are playing, and the arp hold means if I let go of the keys, it stays playing. Sometimes you want that, sometimes you don't. So how can we switch that hold function on or off? Well, we need to press the shift button on the user interface and then tap the arp. Is that handy? Well, personally I don't think, but it's how it works. It would have been more handy if repeated presses of the arp, taps on the arp, would toggle between the three states, but it doesn't. So press the shift and then tap it, and then it goes on hold. Next we find the keyboard range switches, and they are astonishingly simple to use. If I want to split the keyboard, just press the lower key, and then we can use the dial wheel to change the value, or the increase decrease buttons, or very handy of course, if I tap this keyboard button over here, I can simply press a key on the keyboard. And let's also do this, that for the upper key, and now I have set a keyboard range for this part. We can do that of course for any part. Next, every part has a toggle switch for the keyboard control. These are the green switches over here. What does that mean? It means if I would press it to toggle it off, this part is not listening to the keyboard anymore. Well, was a little bit confusion with me, because as we can hear right now, it still is listening to the keyboard. But that is because if you tap a part, it becomes the active part. As you can see, a blue rectangle gets around that part. And we can hear now the strings and the drums, but not the Pearly Gate part anymore. It's not listening to the keyboard anymore. How does that differ from the mute? Well, this part can still play, but it's just not listening to the keyboard, but it does listen to MIDI input. So if you play a song via a sequencer or a DAW on your computer, then it will still play. Why is that useful? Well, if you have a song recorded 16 MIDI channels and you want to play along with just the piano sound, then you press all those keyboard buttons for the different parts that you don't want to play yourself, but they still will be audible. And that is where this keyboard button is very handy. The only thing is to be aware that the active part will always play, even if you have put the keyboard off. By the way, when a part is selected, and that happens every time when you press one of the buttons, then it has made a drastic change in the background, because right now the knobs that we have been controlling a while ago are not active anymore for the entire performance. They are only active for the selected or the active part. So if right now I would rotate the cutoff frequency, it will change only the sound of the current selected part, which is the pad choir. And that is a very useful function, of course. However, if you forgot that you have selected a part and you were intending to change a parameter for the entire performance, well, then you first have to select the entire performance again, or deselect a part. Well, I have not found another way of deselecting a part other than pressing the name of the performance, which also pops up this new left bar menu that we can click away. Now we do not have any parts selected anymore. So the big plus is the knobs over here can operate on performance level or on part level, but it is a bit cumbersome to switch between selecting or deselecting a part. With the mute button we can silence certain parts, so let's do that for this one and for the drums. And now we only hear the pad. Then we also have the solo buttons, and if I would like to hear only the drums, I can solo it, and that is a quick way, quicker than muting the other ones. Mute is different from the keyboard in the sense that if I take out the keyboard, then the sound module is still active. So if it receives MIDI data, it will still play. If you press the mute, it will also silence for MIDI data. Then we have these volume sliders over here. And there are two ways to operate them. If you select it first, then you can use the dial wheel or even the increase decrease buttons to change the volume, or the shift increase decrease buttons to change it by 10, or alternatively we can use the slider on the user interface, and you can see that now it moves the blue arrow. The volume does not change until I magnet on the white dot, and now they change together. So let's do it again for the pad. Yeah, that is that's of course done to avoid any very sudden large volume changes. And now you may ask, hey, weren't there 16 parts in a performance and I see only 8? Yeah, that's true. And for that we have this view field over here that we can tap, and now we get a different screen where we see that we can select 4 parts at a time, and yeah, and we can also see by these green dots that we have only 3 parts working. But I could tap over here and then we get parts 13 to 16 in view, and if they would have been filled we would see exactly what we see over here. The interesting part is that the right hand side of the screen has now also changed. It shows the keyboard ranges, so if I would have changed it, I have lost that change somewhere in video making, but let's do that again very quickly. Yes, that was quick, and now we can see over here a keyboard range for this particular part. There's more to this right hand side screen that has to do here with the new pink bar, that is the velocity. That is the key velocity range that we can change in exactly the same fashion. We can use our hand to try use the velocity that we like. Well, that is a bit cumbersome. I think I rather use the number input and say velocity 20. And then at the top I want velocity, I don't know, 90. And that means that these keys now only play in this keyboard range and in this velocity range. Above or below, we won't hear this part. There's more to it. There is another screen that shows the volume of all the elements. But before we can see that, we need to make one little change. Go to the motion control and here in the slider function, move to element. And now we go back to the home screen, and all of a sudden we see here on the right hand side 8 sliders, those are the volume sliders for the 8 elements, and I can change them with the sliders, or I can select them and change them with the dial wheel. So that will probably change the sound, and I don't even know how much, because this is an FM sound, so sometimes small changes are drastic. That's for an FM part, but let's have a look at a wave part. Yeah, now I have 8 sliders for the 8 elements in this wave part, and I can operate these sliders independently of each other. And when we have a drum part selected, then something similar happens, but now we have the 8 main drum elements that we can change the volumes of. So, well, all in all, this performance screen is really, really, really very versatile, and we can already do a lot of stuff over here to change the sound. However, there's a lot more. We haven't touched any of the important parameters of the sounds yet, and saved a sound as a new sound, and that's what we are going to do in the next video, or maybe the second next, because the next video, it might be interesting to first see how we can import a variety of new sounds that we can download from the internet. See you back there.